Welcome to the lesson on constructing right triangles. In this lesson, we will use the basic properties of constructions to create right triangles. Now, like any other triangle, right triangles can be constructed by following a few basic principles, and of course remembering the basic definition. To ensure that there is a right angle, the essential quality of a right triangle, a segment bisector would be recommended. So let's talk about what would ensure that we get a segment bisector. So I can draw any segment and give that segment the two endpoints. Open up my compass to more than half of my segment with two arcs, one below and one above, with the same distance. Construct two arcs from the other endpoint, and then with two points at both of those dual arc intersections, connect the two points to properly create my segment bisector. Now, why a segment bisector is so important? Because it also is a perpendicular segment bisector, so it creates a right angle. Now I can take any two points on my original segment and call it a right angle triangle. In fact, I can pick any of the other three quadrants, take another two points, and create another, non-congruent of course, but another right angle triangle. Because I've made one right angle, I'm able to make several others. Now let's jump into copying right angle triangles. And let's say that we start with a hypotenuse and a leg. So over on the side, I can be given any two segments. Now my one segment, the smaller segment, I would go ahead and label the leg. And of course, the larger of the two segments would be properly labeled the hypotenuse. So how would I use the specific length of these two segments in order to create a right triangle with that specific leg and that specific hypotenuse? I can start by constructing a random segment. I would go ahead and make it a pretty decent size length and construct the segment bisector of that segment. Of course, the segment bisector will give us a 90 degree angle. So once I've done that, I can go ahead and once again connect the two intersections, thus ensuring I have a 90 degree angle. Now that I know I have a 90 degree angle, I can go ahead and specifically measure out the one leg that I've been given. And with that measurement, on either side, on either segment, place an arc that would specifically give me the length of that leg. That's my second leg. Now, with the length of the hypotenuse, I can go to the new point of the new leg that I've made and create an arc for my new hypotenuse that'll be the same. As you can see, my hypotenuse is too long, so I can simply line up my straight edge and lengthen up this segment. But the intersection of that line and the arc for my hypotenuse will give me a hypotenuse of equal measure to my original. Thus, I've copied this right triangle with the set hypotenuse and set leg. Now, could I copy another right triangle, but instead with a given angle and hypotenuse? So here I've been given the angle and given the set length of my hypotenuse. So I will start much the same way by constructing a random length segment, but at least one that's sizable enough. And from this, I will go ahead and open my compass to the specific measure of that hypotenuse and mark that measure out above and all the way through, almost all the way through down to my segment. So my hypotenuse will be somewhere, of course, up there, but now I need to find the specific angle. So I will put a point on one of the rays of the angle and mark it off on the bottom segment that I already have. I'll put another point on the other ray so I can find the specific width of that angle. And from that point, I can find another arc or create another arc that intersects with the hypotenuse arc, thus creating the proper hypotenuse length at the proper angle size. However, we do not have a guaranteed right angle yet. So now what we have to do is open up our compass at the point at which the hypotenuse intersected with the other arc and quickly drop down another perpendicular segment. So I can do this by dropping down a full arc that intersects one of the sides of my angles and from each of those intersections, draw two arcs. And from the intersection of those two arcs, I can make a point that connects to my top point. And these two points intersecting with the original segment create a right angle. Thus, I have a right angle triangle with the given angle size and the given hypotenuse. Now, when it comes to constructing special right triangles, I can go ahead and use some tricks to create an isosceles right triangle. That is a right triangle with two equal sides. Now, I've started with a perpendicular bisector already made, so now I will go ahead and examine the measurement lengths possible with my compass. And I'm going to set my compass to about 4 centimeters. That way, I can pick any point on one of the segments and draw a 4-centimeter arc and make sure that that arc intersects the perpendicular segment. Now, from this point, connected to the intersection of the other arc and the segment, I will have a right angle triangle that guaranteed has a hypotenuse of 4 centimeters. And again, I don't know what these legs will be, but I do know that the angle is 90 degrees. From one of the other quadrants, I can go ahead and take that same setting and create a large arc that intersects both rays. Now, because that compass was the same, both of these legs of my eventual right triangle will both be congruent. They'll both be 4. I won't know what the hypotenuse will be for now, but I do know that I've made a isosceles right angle triangle using just some of the basic tricks of a compass and a straight edge.